good afternoon everyone, sorry for the delay. So let me have I'm sure you must be knowing the agenda for today. So still I would like to have the preamble from the deans, and once they will deliver the preamble, I would be there for CBCS presentation. So over to you, Dr. Saleem, and I think Dr. Sharma is also there. So Dr. Sharma, okay. So dear students, good afternoon. This is I'm presenting before you some of the options, which some of the initiatives of the university which we have started just recently, and these are like the first one is choice based grade system. You must have heard about CBCS through UGC mandate, through National Education Policy 2020, and there are many initiatives. This is very important because all initiatives can be linked to the only CBCS. CBCS talks about freedom which you have, flexibility which you have in your program. So the first purpose why we are going is, right now it's all mandatory from our side, except elective you cannot have any option to choose. But we want to shift this teacher centric system to student centric or learner centric system. What to learn, where to learn, how to learn, in what way you have to learn, all that has to be decided by you. Because you are the one who is learning, you are the one who needs degree. So, but only thing is, we have kept the system to be fixed for first year. Rest all, you second year to final year, you can do all experiments, you can choose subjects from your own basket, you can choose core subjects from other domain as well. And we are making this system to be, broad-based. So this is all about learner autonomy. We are also giving you option. Instead of your own electives, you can have interdisciplinary courses, you can have multidisciplinary approach, you can choose project from other domain, you can go for suppose the school of pharmacy, other than you can choose some of the subjects in school of business from other school. Suppose you want to do you want to learn programming, you want to take up the subjects of maybe artificial intelligence, how it works with your business. So all these things can be learned by you. You can spend 6 months in the industry. Right now you are spending only 6 months. You can spend one year with the industry. You can have self-paced learning. How many credits, which semester you have to learn, that you can decide. You can take up, suppose your semester is for 25 credits, you can take up 30 credits. If your semester is for 25, you can make it 22. Your pointer is less. So in that case, you can say, oh, I will opt for less subjects this semester, let me improve my pointer, and next semester I can cope up and I can register for extra subjects, and so on. The credit transfer with industry. So you can do the industrial training that, and they can transfer the credits to you in lieu of your semester. Now, what are the options? You can drop a course, you can withdraw a course, you can drop a complete term, you can get for additional learning. Look at additional learning. Additional learning is, you can just for, because you want to learn some subjects, you can register and you can be getting the certification. You can get diploma, you can get post diploma. The students who have CGPA more than 7 can be permitted to do a course or credit from PG level. So BBA students can join PG courses. The B Pharma students can learn subjects of M Pharma, and so on. The FFC, the MCOM students can learn, the BBA finance students can learn from the subjects of higher semester MBA finance, and so on. You can go for intra school as well. The SFS students can learn some subjects from computer science, maybe SOB, and so on. You can complete the degree, you can complete the credits, you can complete your credits. You can complete your credits within, suppose your course is for 4 years, you can do your complete your credits in 3 years. If your course is for 3 years, you can do it in 2 years. But the degree would be awarding only at the end of the prerequisite time. The slow learner can extend their degree up to N+2. These are the promotion rules which are going to be applicable for each one of you. I'm not sure whether you know these rules or not, but you can see these are available on the website as well. So first, the how would be promotion rule from first sem to third sem. So the total 60% of total credits from, suppose your first sem and second sem together, you have 40 credits. So in that case, 60% of total credits of first and second to be required to earn before you get promoted to third semester. So it means if you have suppose sum of first and second as 40, so for 60% of 40 is going to be your promotion rule for first year to second year. Now second year to third year. So what rule says? So rule says that for minimum number of credits to be earned for registration for fifth term is going to be total credits of first semester, I mean first year. So that those are 40. Then 60% of total credits of third and fourth year. These two, summation of these two is going to be your minimum credits. Minimum number of credits to be earned before seventh term. It is total credits of first year plus total credits of second year plus 60% of fifth and sixth. What is the minimum pointer which is required for undergraduate degree to complete in GU? It is 5. And the postgraduate degree, it is 6 CGPA. Until unless you acquire that, you will not be allowed to complete your degree. Even if you have done your course, then you have to stay back. You have to do some, take up some courses in the grade improvement, and you have to acquire the minimum, and then the degree would be given. What about non-engineering credits or credits may, so non-engineering, the credits may change, but the formula remains same. So far, your whatever subjects you have registered, you were giving exam for the same. But now the registration, course registration is separate and exam registration is separate. What you can do is you have done course registration. You feel those are many, many courses. I cannot take up so many exams. You can put one course in the arrear. You can give exam for the rest of the courses. This course, which is in arrear, next year or next semester, you can appear for examination of the same course after due preparation. So that is also allowed. What are the options open right now this year with immediately with winter 2020 session? Students can pointer above 7 can register for PG courses. Students who can choose elective from other school. So SOB can select from rest of the 13 schools of the university. The students can choose the elective program of the same school with other program. Like SOB students, School of Business Administration can take up some courses of aviation and logistic as well. And vice versa. Students major 18 credits extra. You can get in major certificate and major on your degree with registering 18 credits from the same school. How? You can do PG courses, you can do some industry-driven courses, you can do multiple electives and so on. Master of Business Administration with minor in Entrepreneurship. Master of Business Administration with minor in AI. Master of Business Administration with minor in Finance. So you can get these degrees with 18 credits extra. Master of Finance can do the same with any of the school which are present. Suppose you got a job in some manufacturing company, you can do a minor in mechanical as well to understand manufacturing process and so on. For credit transfer scheme, you can do a credit transfer with the, some institute, or you can do a credit transfer with some maybe industry as well. Grade improvement, we have already launched. The students who have pointer less than 6 can apply for the grade improvement. And grade improvement would be, you can register for maximum 10% of total credit. Suppose your degree is for 120 credits, maximum courses wherein you can apply can be 12 credits only. Slow learner. So those who are slow learner, those who have pointer less than maybe 6, they can enroll for credits less than 20 in a current semester. If they have registered for 25, 28, they can reduce. Students can register one subject extra through Coursera, NPTEL, e-learning, and exam would be conducted by the university, but learning could be from any mode, EDX, Coursera, NPTEL, e-learning, and so on. So that's it from my side. Now I please remember these dates. We are on 22nd, although this message has been given to everyone. So you have to give your information, consent to your dean and PC, and the program chair have to approve this on the iCloud. After taking due approval from VC office and your respective dean on 28th of December. If you have some of the queries, I can respond to those. So any query for any of the school, but then it's a beautiful system. It is like kind of platter. You decide how much hungry you are, what you want to eat, how you want to eat, what time you want to eat, when you want to graduate, everything. You link that with a cafeteria system. We always link CBCS with the cafeteria system. It's a known example use case study, we can say. So it is open for question answer. If any questions are there, otherwise I will log out and then deans can reply and those can be added in the FAQ. Is there any fee? No. For opting any additional course, there is no fee. That's the beauty. It is all academic. Even you go for major or minor, there won't be any fees. So I will be confined to the only CBCS questions if somebody can reply to that. So students who are in the last semester cannot do, unfortunately, but still if you want to learn any course, we can allow you to learn out of your passion. And of course, timetable has to be ready accordingly. Any other questions? So I think there are no questions. So deans, I would log out now and you can reply to the students' queries. And in case you feel, you can share those queries on the Google Doc, which is already being shared with all of you. Thank you so much.